well, maybe it won't stand in the end, but we're going to allow it to stand for now. What's going on here?
Such a good question. A couple things are going on. Probably the protections will be whittled away when they do this.
And we know that redistricting is something that Republicans and Democrats have both admitted they benefited from over the years. Why are they waiting, the Supreme Court justice is waiting until the next term to change something that could impact the outcome of the upcoming election?
It's such a good question. So this case comes to the Supreme Court on something that we've all talked about more and more, which is the emergency docket. This is an emergency appeal. Alabama said, don't make us redraw these laws. Even though there was a unanimous district court, a three-panel court, two appointed by President Trump, one appointed by President Clinton, that said, need to redraw these lines, otherwise it could violate the voting rights of African Americans in Alabama. Here the Supreme Court says, no, let's keep it as is. Now, why are they saying, let's put it off? Because it came up to them as an emergency appeal. And what they're saying is, don't change anything in Alabama now. Wait until we can hear this case as a matter of our typical calendar. What that means practically on the ground is that these particular lines where African Americans are 27% of the population, but a majority in one of seven districts, 14% of the districts, that these will stay in effect for the next election.
So, Jessica, what precedent does this set for other similar voting rights cases? Does this mean that state law is now preeminent to this Supreme Court?
So, yes and no. I mean, I think this is, in a lot of ways, an important decision, but it is an order that comes from the emergency law. It's not a full decision on the merits that happens when, as we were just talking about, the court sets this case for calendar. There's a full briefing, there's amicus briefs, there's oral arguments. So we need to be careful about saying it's precedent setting in the sense that it tells us a new perspective. I think it previews for us what the court's new perspective will be. But in terms of precedent, I think, again, we should be circumspect because it is a decision that comes on an emergency appeal. It's not a full decision.
And wouldn't it be interesting if there was a great exodus of Democrats moving Republicans from districts or vice versa? It's messed up the math system completely, but we know that's probably not going to happen.
We know it probably will not happen. Sorry. And we know, of course, that this is so important for the balance of power and that there are a lot of decisions that are being made on the state court level as we speak, dealing with this, you know, vital process of redrawing district lines, and that the states are doing a lot more work now because I think what they see happening in the Supreme Court, which is them kind of saying, hands off, we don't want to be that active.
Jessica Levin, so thank you for breaking all of that down. We appreciate it. Well, Italy has implemented some of the strictest protocols in the world to combat COVID-19.
That's right, the rules largely apply to the unvaccinated population in the country. Unvaccinated Italians are barred from entering many public places in Italy and from using various modes of public transportation. However, some Italians have discovered a creative solution to fulfill their travel needs. CBS News foreign correspondent Chris Lissay reports from Venice.
Dante's Inferno, it was the damned who were carried across the River Styx for their sins. Today, in Pogonera, Venice, it's the unvaccinated who depend on boatmen and Andrea Savogliano.
I go into like a charity opera. I don't ask for money for this.
An estimated 5,000 Venetians aren't vaccinated, meaning that with few exceptions, water buses are off limits.
So we can't escape from our island. Is the only way to reach your job or to reach your school?
So they got organized. And now those with boats help out the rest.
Where are you going?
To survive or are you going to my job number?
It's an underground network Savogliano likens to Jewish Christians hiding in the catacombs.
When you are a minority, it's people, they are afraid for their jobs, for their families.
To be clear, the unvaccinated can still board ferries to get medical help, or if their minors going to school. Venice City Councilman Marco Gasparinetti says those who choose to skip the vaccine
must be prepared for the consequences.
Results, according to a recent study.